And in Indonesia, the Lunar New Year Eve has lifted the spirit of holiday celebrations. Various activities were held to welcome the coming of the Year of the Rabbit. A correspondent in Jakarta reports.
Jakarta's ethnic Chinese community held various activities to welcome the Lunar New Year Wednesday. About 10,000 ethnic Chinese thronged to the Dharma Bhakti Temple in Jakarta's Chinatown to mark the occasion. Some were praying while others were burning fireworks or searching for tuberose flowers to take home as part of the Chinese New Year tradition. The Chinese New Year summit occurred at around 11:50 at night. This time is believed by the ethnic Chinese community as the right time to express their hope for the new year.
May the Indonesian government be more prosperous, more successful, and may all the people in Indonesia be able to live and rejoice.
Indonesian Chinese have only been allowed to celebrate the Lunar New Year since 2000, when the country's former president repealed a decree passed by his predecessor Suharto in 1967, banning the ethnic Chinese from celebrating the New Year in public.
I hope in this New Year of the Rabbit, hopefully everything becomes better. All beings be happy, and the Indonesian people can be more prosperous. I hope there are no more riots and everybody can live in peace.
The celebration was also a wet one, which has a special meaning.
This is the year of the wooden rabbit. If the wood element is facing the fire element, it will easily burn. Chinese people say that the element of wood is very good if facing the water element. It will be fertile. If the rain comes, it will be fertile. So if the rain happens in the year of the wooden rabbit, it will bring good fortune, which is also the hope of every ethnic Chinese.
Ethnic Chinese make up just 4% of the country's population of more than 237 million. NTD News, Jakarta, Indonesia.